This is now hour 21 of 24 terrible hours. 21 is a number that is so close to 24. I'm very excited about that. And those are so close. Oh my God, we're at 3261. Thanks to everybody is strong of will and terrific. So in this hour, we have a document, which is called Metabods. It is men who want more. And in this hour we've got Adam Bozarth. Hello.
Hello.
We got JW Friedman.
He's here.
Oh, he's here. He'll be back in a sec. We got Frank West.
Hello.
Achilles Healy's.
Hi.
Myself. And then looks like we got Kumquat back in the room.
I want more.
Add more, man.
More, man.
There is this document provided to us by Fatty Bobatty, and thank you so much for it. Fatty Bobatty notes in the document that these guys are absurdly wordy, so this has been edited down considerably. Kumquat Sipe, just so you know, there is a random story button on the site. All of this is going to metabods.com, the logo for which is the Maury Povich logo. So that's fun. And the site is actually pretty nicely, like, good minimalist design. We have a mission statement to start off with. I'm going to direct your attention to page 2 in the document here. And Achilles Healy's, I have some questions I want to ask you.
Oh, great.
So what is Metabods?
Well, it's a place that celebrates Metabods, you know.
I don't know. What are Metabods?
Metabods can be anything you want. Metabods are expressions of the desire to transform and improve the human male form. These improvements can take a variety of forms, but usually they involve the enhancement of whatever you find alluring about the male body.
The male body? Aren't there fantasies about women too?
Theoretically, yes.
I mean, that is, there's material about female metabods out there, including things like multi-breast fantasies, Amazon growth, etc.
But it's all guys here.
Listen, I don't want my children learning a male-only curriculum. Alternative theories must be presented.
All guys, huh? So this stuff is all gay, right?
No, not all of it. Many or most of our stories involve erotic encounters between male metabods, but not all.
Still, on the whole, it's pretty much gay.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, on the whole.
Hey, give me an example. What do you guys dream about?
Well, it's all very individual. Muscle growth in moderation or extreme is one popular category.
Okay.
There's also replication, cloning, the growth of a second body, or twinning, the splitting of a body into two exact forms. Cock growth, increasing size a few inches or a few feet.
Ugh.
Macro, growth in size beyond the range possible for humans. Micro, shrinking, which can be down to a few feet or a few inches or even smaller. Body swapping, placing your mind in another body. And centaur forms and various kinds of extras. Extra limbs, digits, cocks, even heads. Twinning, which is basically extra bodies, falls into this too.
I like that the sketch just had these stacks of dick cards. Pulled out.
Send cord, though.
Okay, so how did Metabots start? I want to know.
Funny story.
No, that is true. Can't wait for the funny story.
Yeah. Well, somewhere around 1996, I discovered Josh Dugan's multi-limb stories on the net at Nifty. That's a link. Let's go.
Yeah, here we go. I love Nifty things. Oh, nifty.org. I've seen this site before.
Yeah, well, I was at that great place. The Comprehensive Erotic Story Archive.
Yep.
I was entranced. It was like coming out all over again. I'd always thought that I must be the only one who had fantasized about guys with extra arms, among other things.
96, so this guy had a sexual awakening while playing Mortal Kombat.
Finish me.
There's something about this Goro character.
Goro, and then I just lay down.
And here were these stories on the net for all the world to see. If there was another guy, there had to be more. I was immediately inspired to write my first two multi-limb stories, Body Shop and Army Experiment.
This guy wrote Army Experiment?
Yeah, this guy wrote Army Experiment. Yeah,
no. Who is this guy?
Well, that's the thing. He had all of that money left over from when, from when Disney bought that. Let's see. Looks like we bought Marvel and what's this other thing? Oh, fuck.
Just get Joss Whedon on it. It'll be fine. Still two of my personal favorites, as your firstborn often are, brackets G, which I submitted to Nifty. The Nifty archivist duly posted my stories, but then sent me a note that suggested that perhaps one prolific offer in this vein might be enough for his site.
Oh,
Damn.
At first I was
ain't angry. Room enough for two prolific authors on this website. And I'm feeling pretty fucking prolific today.
At first I was angry at being discouraged. So soon after my revelation, but later, I realized he was right in a way. The proportion of one writer to all the writers on Nifty is probably not dissimilar to the proportion of gay guys interested in multi-limb stories in relation to the gay population. That's a statistic I don't understand. So, being a web developer, I started my own website sometime in 1997. Mm-hmm. Since then, it's had several incarnations, but at its root, it's always been a story archive for specialized fantasies that are hard to find in generalist sites like Nifty. Originally, there were very few such sites, and none featuring multi-limbs. Recently, more have developed, as well as Yahoo groups and other forums.
Oh, yay! Yahoo!
Yahoo!
So you guys excited?
So excited. So, we're going to move to the next section of this document, and this section is called Fuck Beasts and the Men Who Love Them.
Thanks, Don Mori.
Excellent. Okay, first story, I was actually skimming this, and, here we go! Okay!
I like that drawing.
that is a great drawing. So happy! It found their All right.
I just want to acknowledge somebody in the Twitch just said fuck beasts of the southern wild and it made me laugh out loud really hard.
Oh shit. Well, Mbop anyway. We're at $3,366.66, which is a great number, actually.
Yay!
Thank you, Lionhead.
So that's 333.6.66, which is a terrific number to have. Okay, so this has been edited down somewhat conspicuously, but Adam Bozarth,
yeah,
if you will take this first story here entitled Human Tar.
You and your bud have finally found the internet site you were looking for. Searching for what seemed like hours doing a Google search, you tried every combination of the word centaur, magic, transformation, and you finally found the magic internet site you've heard of. All you had to do at the site was point and click on the centaur icon. And you become a centaur.
Wow, that's some good web development. What's that written in?
It's great development, poor SEO. Your bud had encouraged you because your bud always has been hot on the fantasy of you as a... You've been riding your bud around town bareback, loving him. Your shoulders have grown bigger and broader along with your back and chest, because centaurs are endowed with godlike torsos, and in proportion to their stallion horse bodies, your hair had grown to back length, and while riding you, your bud made it into a sexy ponytail.
Just like me and my buds.
Mm-hmm. Later, you and your bud had awesome sex.
Yeah, bro!
And you had pumped him so full of your centaur cum from the huge Ooh. Centaur penis between your front legs and your back legs that you all had become. Hmm?
Is that one penis or is that multiple penises?
Like, no, one for each. Every set of legs that an animal has, they have a penis between those legs.
Ah, okay.
That's how biology is.
Yeah, got it.
You fold him so full of cum that your bud has become kind of drunk due to the intoxicating effect of your cum on his body. It's worked on him like a love potion, and he's all yours now, and you're loving it because he's a stud in his own right.
But you've already fucked him, so what do you care? Don't what?
Now he's mine forever.
Okay.
You've had a great day of running and swimming in the lake with him on your back and making love to him, and now you're both satiated with penises half aroused and lazy. Your powerful horse body wants to be fed. Let's go to the Patrick Supply Store and get you some oats, your bud suggests, from his prone position lying on your glistening stallion's back, his arms around your waist. You realize that the oats sound good to you, and you realize it's because you're mostly a horse now.
Oh, great. I'm a horse now.
And at the same time, other realizations occur to you. Ugh, I hadn't thought of that, you tell your bud, realizing that a lifetime of eating oats isn't what you had in mind. Besides, your human teeth aren't up to the task that a horse's would handle easily.
This drawing.
No more pizza, bro.
This drawing, by the way, is amazing.
Yeah, the drawing right now.
Whoa.
Oh, goodness. Ouch. It's more of a cock centaur with a human face on the
But it's like a human
face. No, it's a Halloween costume for a dicktar.
It's a human face of a guy named like Chet.
Yeah, Chet the dicktar.
I'm very into the idea of every single one of these having the exact same face, though.
Yeah.
You're not wild about the oats, your bud asks, hearing the nonplussed tone in your voice. You may as well learn to like 'em, big guy, he laughs and gives your waist a friendly squeeze. He gently digs his heels into your flanks while remaining lying face down as he relishes your massive equine male B.O.D. Being human
wasn't so bad, but it's really cool having four legs. I'm just starting to realize that, starting with eating oats, there are several things about being part horse that make it best as a short-term proposition. You mean you still want to be a centaur, but human, your bud asks?
Adam, if you will scroll down to the part that starts, this is cool.
This is cool, you say, checking out your four human legs.
Oh, God!
Your hands confirm that you, to you, that they're real. But with actual human skin and muscle, your back has extended rearward from your front legs to your back legs, and you turn around a couple of times to get used to walking with 4 feet. You realize you've gotten to keep the genital bonus that came with being a centaur, because each pair of a Sumantar's legs has its own genitals between them. Thankfully,
plus two to ball dick.
So his butt is David Cronenberg, I guess.
Yeah. Sorry, I just got a very strange look. A thumbs up.
The drawing is now too many dicks.
Oh my goodness. So thankfully, as you check them out, you realize proudly that you're still something of a horse in that department. Well, you've certainly qualified for an improved food menu, your bud says. It won't be cheap as oats, especially as your appetite increases. Feeding four legs takes more nutrition than feeding two.
That's not how nutrition works.
Shut up.
Oh, that's where food is stored, in the legs.
I store my food in my legs.
Excuse me, bud. I require four times as much food. Now, our roommate situation has evolved dramatically.
You might not want to ask any questions, frankly.
Just don't, yeah, don't worry about the weird jeans I'm sewing.
No matter, you say, concentrating on making your handsome Humantar body more legally presentable in public. Your bud runs to the local Walmart for you and returns with a couple of pair of Levi's 401s, neatly folded, several sizes longer than your former size to fit your new, longer, stronger legs. You pull a pair of them onto your back legs and slip your front legs into the second pair. With your handsome centaur torso, you prefer to go bare-chested, and being barefoot feels very comfortable, especially with four bare feet. I'm starved, you tell your bud. Care to join me? I'm going to get something to eat. Sure, your bud says, and finds there's room enough on your human to hindquarters, and grabbing your shoulders, he pulls himself up onto you. You head outside, grabbing looking for a McDonald's.
Yay!
Since your four legs are giving you double Mac attacks, and your stomach is growling beneath your centaur six-pack abs.
Hey, are your double legs giving you double Mac attacks?
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm a horse monster. But your bud feels nice with his arms around you and his legs draping from your hindquarters. His legs smooth against your four legs affectionately, and you realize he's still yours. The breeze feels great across your shoulders, chest, and back, and a long stretch of lawn you found feels so good on those four bare feet of yours.
You can still wear shoes. Like, you
know. No. Now that I'm a human tar, they have to be nailed onto my feet, so no thanks.
They're probably all weird and misshapen.
I'm traipsing around in public with this jar of talking marijuana on me.
My butt. Yeah, I think this guy's more than your bud if he rides you.
Scrolling down now to page 16.
Yay! Wow, guys.
Oh, thank you so much.
Audio. Thank you
so much, pure malevolent audio. I personally prefer Mbop because it made my Twilight Sparkle plushie into a real Hanson brother for a while.
That's the McGick of the 24 Terrible Hours.
Oh, the Metabods has a McDonald's tattoo.
Double Mac tattoo.
I've been thinking about getting one of those.
Yeah.
Why not? Idiot
corporate sponsorship tattoo?
Look, here's the deal, right? Bodies are temporary, man. You should just get whatever you want on it. Oh my God,
you're totally right. Holy shit.
And the other deal is we are officially sponsored by McDonald's. And every
call. They've been calling a lot. I've been kind of hanging up on them. that's still going through?
Yeah, I mean, we haven't really heard them, but we are assuming that they support 100% of the content we have read.
100%.
Call them back when we're done and see what they have a problem with.
All right, scrolling down here to page 6 in the document, and Kumquat's up.
Oh, boy.
I am very excited about this title. I am really excited about this title.
Oh, no.
Kumquat, what's this story called?
Oh God!
Human Tor.
No.
What?
Scroll down. It's the third story.
Oh my goodness!
Yeah.
Yeah. You're on the wrong one.
Oh my goodness. Let me tell you about the magic tale of Armfuls of Feet.
Yay!
It's such a common fetish.
And not arms full.
Armfuls. No, armfuls. Armfuls. Dude, I've got extra feet for you. Eric said.
God, I don't know. I don't have any room for all these feet. Like, oh God, I guess maybe in the garage, you can throw them in there.
Dad, what are all these feet? Throw them out. You don't need them.
I'm gonna have a garage sale in April, okay?
You're just hurting yourself.
These are worth like $12, and if I fix them up, and I'm thinking about starting my own.
Dad, this one's missing toes. You're really gonna use this one?
This one is a promotional foot. You can't get this anymore. I've looked on eBay.
Eric said, his voice warm with promise. I had been asleep, the light comforter only partly covering me that warm morning, lying nude on my stomach, and my naked shoulder blades felt his warm prods to wake me up. Quote. Sounds nice. I mumbled, instantly hard. I visualized his tall body, splendid, with several pairs of flawless muscular legs, and Eric's own especially beautiful big guy feet, shifting expectantly, waiting for me to see and hold them. I guess I was starting to dream of them, because I awoke again to gentle warm pressure on my back, all over my back. It felt so good. Dude, wake up! Eric said. I've been doing more feet for you, and they're bigger and better looking.
More feet.
I think I'm in love with them myself. I said, loving the thought. I was so warm and hard. Warm, gentle pressure was prodding my back. I felt a foot gently tousle my hair.
Ooh, that's not healthy.
I don't like that at all.
The big toes lovingly combing it, the arch sliding over my scalp. I smiled, eyes closed. The friendly foot slid down over my ear and neck, resting with warm pressure on my shoulder. I could feel the big toes gently exploring my collarbone. Excuse me, my collarbone.
Oh, very nice. I like that. Yeah.
Then they smoothed under my chin, giving me a very gentle lift upwards to raise my head. I realized another foot was on my shoulder. My other shoulder.
Oh.
Gently pressing my shoulder blade and muscles.
So many sex feet.
I want to point out one John Toast in the chat said, Guy Feet Dickwood. Yes. Thanks, John.
It was Eric's voice, soft and almost pleading. He was leaning over me. I could tell by the warmth radiating off his body, his long, naked male body, the body that my own body would love forever. I could feel the warmth of his breath as his lips brushed my ear. Please, I need you to help me have sex with my feet, dude.
Please, I need you to help me have sex with my feet, dude.
I also started shooting hot molten cream on the spot.
Molten
cream.
What is it when it's in its solid state then?
You know, just regular hot cream.
Okay.
Yeah. I was so lost in his touch. His beautiful male feet, graceful and poised, were now so large, it was unbelievable.
Sometimes when we touch, you help me fuck my feet.
Your feet become so large. So large it might be too much.
They were touching me all over, prodding my chest and arms, resting on me, and a couple of the big, handsome feet gently caressed my face and hair. They hung heavily from what were several pairs of Eric's longest, handsome arms. Pairs and pairs of them!
You skip down to, we finally pulled up at our destination, please.
Wow. Wow, this keeps going.
Sure does, and this is the truncated version.
Wow.
Those feet were on me, and they were on me, and I felt them pressing me.
They were feet.
We finally pulled up at our destination, the beach. And tumbled headlong out of the driver's door. Wait, how the fuck did this thing get in the car? I assume that was the last, like, 17 paragraphs.
Their other friend is Turbo Team. They rode there in him.
As Eric's hands gently and powerfully pulled me along, he wouldn't have me apart from him. His legs spilling out the truck, leaping from the interior, from the carpet, following us like a beautiful human male centipede, running with us like a crowd of athletes. Virile, male, very beautiful and sexy, Eric's proud torso riding upon the herd of legs like a cowboy at roundup. And the waters frothed and foamed as Eric's feet pounded the surf, its coolness refreshing them, and his immense penises, which he and I sucked as we laughed.
I'm sucking your dick, dude. It's hilarious. Suck the other one, bro.
I realized that I was riding my own herd of legs, and we crazily veered out of the water up the sand dune, falling over and laughing like children. Our big male bodies nude and aroused, loving each other and wild about our legs and feet. I held him, kissing him, feeling my many legs happily snuggled with Eric's herds of legs and large, beautiful feet without number nestled with us as we kissed and fondled them, aroused and coming as we made love to them and each other.
My brain's throwing a 404 error right now.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like...
I felt my face framed in his many gentle hands, so large and comfortable on me, and I closed my eyes as he kissed me. His lips were wonderful on mine, and he smelled so nice, so young and male. I wanted to faint as his eyes locked with mine, and we kissed again. Thanks for loving me, he said.
Excellent. Oh my god, thank you. That was powerfully erotic. Just definitely now watching this drawing of this like muscle centipede.
The human conga line.
That 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 that
I need you to fuck my feet, dude.
All right. This is a three-part story now. Adam Bozarth, yeah. I want you to take the first sort of odd number. Okay, we're going to the email ad promised to grow my penis a foot, and it did.
Oh,
wow.
Adam, you're going to take the first and then alternating lines of dialogue, and then I will take the second and alternating lines of dialogue.
Oh.
And, yeah, okay. And then J.W. Friedman, we are on the email ad promised to grow my penis a foot, and it did. You will be taking the narration, please.
Okay.
All right.
So you want me to start with the dialogue here?
No. We got the dialogue covered. You're doing the non-dialogue parts.
It's okay. So let's see here.
All right. So Adam, start us off.
Yeah,
sorry.
Whoa, dude. No. Oh.
Dude, your foot is leaking puss.
That's not puss. It's cum. Please.
Oh, really? Let's see.
Hey, not the tongue. Oh.
Smack, smack. Yep, that's cum. Man, you're wired and funny.
Still losing, I guess. You need more licks.
Well, now your foot seems to be clean.
Oh, yeah. You really cleaned my clock.
Hey, speaking of which, can I see how the pendulum is connected?
What?
Huh?
Well, like, how are your three legs connected to your body?
Oh, well, let's duck into the changing room, and I'll show you.
Walking on 2 feet with his middle leg bent at the knee, you walk to the locker room.
Too much stimulation.
Agreed.
The three-legged man explains, and inside he slowly pulls off his shirt and then teases you by edging down the sides of his three-legged trunks with his thumbs. He turns to give you a view of his backside, and your eyes go wide as you see the start of two butt cracks.
One butt, two cracks.
Yep. His thumbs tuck the back of his suit under the curve of his buttocks. As he spreads his legs, you can see his hairy nutsack between two of the legs. Then you look closer and see it's stretched around the middle leg with one nut on each side of it. As he turns, you can see his treasure trail disappear into a hairy thigh. You like gasp, that. Agape, as you realize his cock is his third leg.
He's only got one treasure trail?
Only one treasure trail.
Okay, okay.
He blushes and says,
"You know those internet ads that promise you they'll grow your penis a foot? Well, they work."
He wiggles the toes on the middle leg. You stand there staring.
Ew! And then...
It's got dumb. Why did my brain decide to picture that one?
And then...
This and email asked me to grow my penis a foot, and it did. Asterisk.
You gently cradle his foot in his hands, tentatively. You reach out with his index finger to touch the tip of his cockhead toes. It's all so surreal.
I think that's me.
Yeah, that is you.
Okay. I played piggies with these?
You look at his grinning face, and he nods. You press your cheek against the sole of his foot. He giggles as your light whiskers tickles his soul. The foot feels warm and alive against your cheek.
I hope so.
You begin to slide your face back and forth against the sole of his middle foot. He leans back against a row of lockers and moans. You turned your tongue towards his foot, never allowing your face to break contact with some part of his foot. He shivers as you begin to give him a renewed tongue bath, carefully probing with your tongue between each toe and under each nail. His eyes are closed as his naked body glistens with sweat. He moans unintelligibly. As you open your mouth wide and begin to swallow his toes, his eyes open in surprise. He feels the warm, wet flesh encircling his toes. He tries to speak, but your tongue is too relentless, lapping at the underside of his foot. His soul arches and his back arches, and all he can do is moan in ecstasy. You are definitely going to have to find that website he mentioned, and you remind yourself as you begin to suck on his foot.
Whoa! Dude, I'm going to come.
I love how often these stories use the word surprise, as if you lived in this universe, you'd have the capability for surprise.
Yeah.
He kicks him voluntarily, lifting you off the locker room by your jaw as a heavy, warm goo explodes from his foot into your mouth. Oh, oh dear. You sit sweating. Oh, God. All right. You sit sweating on the locker room floor with heavy trails of white goo coming out of your mouth, even though you swallowed most of it. He extends the hand and invites you to join him in the showers. You hang up your suit, and you're embarrassed by your own massive boner.
Embarrassed!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, what? This old thing?
There's no toes or anything.
He tells you not to worry. As you enjoy the shower, he lets you suds up his legs and notice your boner seems to be getting bigger. You are flushed, but you remember to ask where you could get some of that stuff for your other penis, too. He laughs and points at your crotch. You look down and are startled to see that your penis head is differentiating into five toes.
So no leg, just like it splits into five equal parts?
Five toes. Yeah,
yep. It'll take about a week to transform you, and you really need to watch out for athlete's foot, but soon we'll just be a couple of three-legged guys.
Have you heard of Vibram foot shoes, he asks.
But how,
you ask.
My cum contains the essential ingredient. Yours will, too, when we're done.
Yo!
Batty Bo Batty.
The cum contains the essential ingredient.
Thank you. Thank you. That's a concession prize for reading all of this.
Dude, bro, your foot is donating sex money to the stream guy, fella.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, Chief.
No fucking way!
He clutches your deformed penis and begins massaging the foot, which gets hard and delivers a gooey spurt onto his chest. Jesus.
Oh, great. Now I'm gonna have to get a whole new wardrobe.
You gasp with the realization that none of your pants have three legs. And you laugh. And embrace your three-legged friend for a passionate kiss. Your goo pressed between your abs and his dissolves under the hot stream of water as you two slow dance under the shower. Bop by Hanson.
Metabods, American style.
Slow dancing.
Oh man. Okay. Jesus.
Oh,
Jesus. One of these has the tag of bracket.
Super gross. Yeah, I just found that. That's strange. Why would it have that?
All right. Yeah, you're right. I think we should close on the football one. Frank West, you want to take the football one?
I mean, you know I love football.
It's called football.
Football. It wasn't an ordinary football game, that's for sure. All the guys were big and handsome, and they played barefoot. They all had big, handsome... I'm sure it was a dream, because the football they were all throwing around and holding close to them wasn't really a football, but a magic foot. A big, sexy, shapely, and handsome male foot.
That sounds hard, actually.
Yeah, I don't think it's not aerodynamic. Yeah.
Hard to get a good spiral going on that thing.
All the guys liked to hold it and pet it and kiss it, and it had a magical effect on them. It made their feet bigger and handsomer. Mm. Hey, come on! Run the ball down the field! She don't fucking kiss the ball! We fucking talked about this in practice!
Good foot.
Fucking hustle out there! Jesus! They get so turned on by the magic foot. It seemed friendly and warm and was very sexy, and all the guys loved to hold it and kiss it. Before long, the guys had big, really handsome feet and were so turned on by each other's feet, they were laughing and grabbing each other's ankles and licking and kissing and tickling each other's feet. Tackle him, you tackle him! The guy who held the magic foot longest was kissing and licking its beautiful arch and soul when its magic tore his football uniform pants and a second pair of legs ripped out the back.
Ouch.
He laughed, carrying the magic foot with pants legs on his front legs and his second ass and his hind legs nude, but he had four big, beautiful, huge, handsome feet.
That would help. That's good in football.
It's very good.
Yeah.
He tried to hold on to the magic foot, but his hands turned into big, handsome feet also.
Oh, no.
Less helpful now. Seems like an impediment.
Of big, handsome feet.
Big, beautiful male feet hanging there at the end of his long arms and strong fists. Soon, all the guys were running after the magic foot, and before long, they all had four legs and four huge, beautiful feet. Their hands were also feet, and they were so clumsy as they tripped and stumbled with their four beautiful feet. They were also totally turned on and helpless with laughter, plunging their feet into each other's huge penises.
Oh boy.
Ooh.
Penises get involved in this.
You're kicking me in the dick, huh?
Yeah, bro.
They were... Holy way I did that. I don't want to read that one again.
Okay.
They laughed and came and tickled each other until they had tears in their eyes, licking and kissing and nuzzling each other's big, beautiful male feet.
Football.
Football.
That's football.
Are you ready for some foot nuzzling?
no, we're canceled. That makes sense. That makes sense.
Yeah. I don't actually know how we got in those meetings in the first place.
Oh, sorry.
No, I never wanted to play football anyway.
I've just been hanging around the studio with my guitar and stuff, so.
I just want to do before we take off here this section right here. I don't need to tell you what the story is called. So Jay, if you just take this piece right here.
Okay. Take the sock off, Jeremy said. He had removed several socks from the pile of stocking feet and had a nice mound of Eric's pretty handsome male feet piled up. I found myself...
Eric and his feet again.
Fucking leaving them everywhere. God damn it.
Eric, I'm tripping over your feet everywhere I go.
I found myself taking off the sock from the foot I held, and sure enough, it was warm and real. Eric had nice feet. And this was exactly like them. It was a left foot. Mm-hmm. This is a left foot, I said to Jeremy. Are they all left feet? Jeremy laughed, finding two left feet and waving them in small circles. No wonder Eric can't dance. He's got two left feet.
Laughing music!
But there were right feet in the pile.
Ha! Ha!
But!
Ha!
But there were right feet in the pile, too. What? For some reason, we knew Eric would be turned on by all his extra feet, and he was. Pulling himself off from the shower.
For some reason.
He smiled. I thought I only had four. It was my turn to feel like whooping. When and Eric grown 4 feet.
4 feet! It's ass-kicking time! Let's go, motherfucker!
I was out of socks, and all I could find to wear were four ones. Eric smiled, looking at Jeremy. Thanks to you. Now how am I going to get dressed with four legs? Dig it. Oops, laughed Jeremy.
Yay!
So many misunderstandings.
So many macho mans.
So many macho men.
It's the one thing I'm good at, really. So.
No, I like the Macho Man.
No, it's always great when it shows up.
I think this might be my favorite drawing of the hour, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
I love you, football.
He's playing for the Dick Hughes.
I learned that the big secret of Macho Man is you're kind of low, but then sometimes you go really high, but then you go back down low again.
Yeah, you rise to the top. It always rises to the top.
That, just like the cream, dig it. That's just for the people at home. All the kids watching, looking at the Macho Madness.
Oh, no, he's stuck. He's stuck on Macho Man setting.
Oh, my God. Sorry. Okay.
All right. So, F plus, did we learn anything from this?
Feet.
Yep.
I learned how to play football.
It turns out everyone's really cool if you just force them to grow extra bits all over. Like, it doesn't matter how convenient it is, it's fine.
Rather a sublimated foot fetish, it seems like.
I think it's hilarious and sexy, bro.
Oh, it is. It is hilarious.
I love how plot was so tertiary to everything, you know. All of them just could have been like, there's a guy with a lot of feet, but more feet than you're thinking, and he rubs them on you.
You're right, it's dicks and feet.
He starts out with not that many feet, and then he has more feet, and then he gets more feet than that.
You can imagine it.
A lot of feet are involved.
No, I think this whole thing has been a shill for the Levi's company. trying to get us really enticed to have extra legs, so we buy...
That's right. This hour was sponsored by Levi's. And again, they are fully supportive of everything we are reading.
You like this material, you should go buy Levi's. We're gonna be back very briefly. We might have Boots Ranger, who knows? We'll have Jack Chick, we'll have Portex, and we'll have any of these people that want to stick around. So Yeah, stick around. Take a break. Take a lap. I'm definitely going to do that. Oh my God, Boots is still awake. Holy shit, Boots is still... Everyone give Boots applause. All right. Yeah, we'll be taking a break. Take a lap. We'll be right back. And the next one is less, much less gross.